Welcome, everybody, to the combined Denver and Boulder Java Users Group meeting. I'm Greg Ostrovich. We're still meeting online because of COVID restrictions. Hopefully someday, once we get the vaccines figured out, we can start meeting again in person. So just a reminder, we are always looking for DJUG speakers. You can email Matt Rabel or me, or send a message through the Meetup site if you're interested in speaking or have a topic that you'd like to see covered at one of our meetings. Housekeeping announcements, it's corny, but I'm gonna continue to do it. If you need the restroom, hopefully you can find it in your house or wherever you're watching this meeting from. Some of our sponsors, Tech Systems, they sponsor food, but tonight, as always, it's sponsored by whatever's in your pantry or your fridge. But reach out to Courtney Kelterman or Andrew Rawson at Tech Systems if you have any staffing needs. We really appreciate them supporting the Java Users Group. So another sponsor we have is JFrog. They've been doing some awesome giveaways. They'll probably put something in the chat code for that. They'll have a chat. There's a QR code that you use to enter for that drawing. Another sponsor is Apex Systems, and we really appreciate them, Braden Culip. As we always say, since we've been meeting online, the drinks tonight are sponsored by whatever's in your beer fridge. So I'm drinking a milk stout. Develop Intelligence is another sponsor. They give away a Pluralsight, registration so that you can do training. I know I work for the state and we're looking at using Pluralsight as well to provide training for all of our staff. So they're always looking to hire technical instructors who specialize in several technologies for contract opportunities. Those technologies include Java, Golang, JavaScript, React, DevOps tools like Kubernetes and Docker, and many others. And there's a link to Jarrett and to Bob in this case on the slide. So reach out to Bob Clary for more details. Another sponsor is Amazon, and we always appreciate that. It's usually when we meet in person, Chris Almond or Sam Ayer will speak. Because we've been doing it online, we just kind of share what's going on with that. But they're a great sponsor, and we do some awesome giveaways with them. Because they're such a big company, they have a big range of opportunities for their stack, and you can see that there. Okta is another sponsor. That's where Matt works, and we really appreciate their sponsoring the Meetup site that we use and this online meeting. Matt runs it all from wherever he is currently, and I know where that is today, but it varies from time to time. And I'm glad he logged in to do this. So another sponsor is NextGen. Beth Crowley and Sandy Holskin are who we work with. Now they do have an opening. Beth emailed me and they have an opening for a full stack, mid to senior level Java developer using Angular. And there's the position on that slide deck. They give us a gift card, and we really appreciate that. And we'll do the giveaway. Mike will handle the giveaway for that, Mike Suedo. Another sponsor is Agile Learner. That's Venkat Subramanian's company. We give away subscriptions to that site. And they're going to put on an awesome tech conference. It got canceled because of COVID. I don't know when it's going to be rescheduled, but I'm sure that Venkat will get that rescheduled. Another sponsor is JetBrains. They always sponsor a giveaway where we give away IntelliJ or any of the IDEs that they provide. Now it's really just kind of one big IDE that sponsors, that supports multiple languages, but we really appreciate them. They're the Cadillac of IDEs, and they've been sponsoring us for quite a number of years, and we really appreciate that. So I'll let Mike Zuedo handle those door prizes, but if you can support our sponsors, that helps us continue to do these and to have sponsors to pay for food and drink when we meet in person, for the room, et cetera. I always do this. I really appreciate the people that help put this on. So Matt Rabel does the speakers and the locations and does the broadcast, and we just so appreciate that. Without that, we wouldn't be able to do it. So it's awesome. Mike Zueto does the door prizes, and we really appreciate that, and works with the sponsors and puts those slide decks together. And Zeddy Chinfong does all of the operational stuff, including social media, announcements, etc. And I just appreciate all three of them and always want to do a shout out because of the work that they do. Now I'm going to go ahead and bring up Chris Woyna from the Boulder Java Users Group. Since we're a combined meeting, he has some thank yous he'd like to do as well. So Chris?
Hello, everyone. So big thanks. And first, big thanks to Denver Java Users Group. We're essentially a sister organization, and it's great being able to coordinate like this, and also for our speakers. Many of the same thank yous, Tech Systems. We work with Anastasia Alexenko. She's a really great person. If you want to check in about your career, see what's going on, or if you need people, reach out to me and I'll be sure to connect you with her. Normally we meet at Rule 4 Cybersecurity and Emerging Technologies. They were last year's Colorado Technology Association Award winner. No Fluff, Just Stuff and Jay Zimmerman. They do world-class conferences and training. Agile developer Venkat Subramaniam. Also, he does great online training. And if anybody would like a subscription to that, the first person to contact me, I'll get that to you. Also, JetBrains and O'Reilly Books. Back to you, Greg.
Thank you, Chris. By the way, I always broadcast from my kid's bedroom. My oldest son is working full-time and living in Des Moines. So that's why you see this. I usually have a green screen, but not tonight. So there you go. Let's see. We have an awesome talk next month as well. And want to mention that. It's actually going to be on JavaFX, which should be really fun. And that's going to be sponsored by JFrog and Fuji. So, and we'll have details on the meetup site. So without further ado, let me talk about tonight's presentation and introduce the speaker. So tonight's presentation is Controlling Your Race with Micrometer and Spring Boot. Imagine that you're part of a car or race team. You're the one behind the scenes to control the race and make some tough decisions, like changing the team strategy. But you don't have the insights or metrics about your car, opponents, or even the weather. Sounds painful, right? But why are we making this mistake when building our own software? Why don't we implement metrics by default? The logging part is one side of the story, but we also need to know our application health. And that's where Micrometer comes in. It's a library that you can use to define your own custom metrics like timers to check the performance of your microservices, counters to check how many times a certain event is occurring, gauges to check the current value of a variable, and many more. These metrics are exposed by REST endpoints using JSON together with Spring Boot Actuator, which can be saved into a database like Prometheus or Graphite. And to visualize the data, you can use a tool like Grafana. Pretty interesting, right? So in this demo, you will see how you create such applications using Micrometer and Spring Boot. Ready to win this race with it? Jump in. Tonight's speaker is Ko Turk. He is a senior Java developer at Blue for IT, works as a full stack engineer creating microservices and building front end applications. Ko speaks and presents at conferences like JavaZone, DevNexus, and JFall about IDEs, Micrometer, and consumer-driven contract testing. His speaker credentials can be found at ko-turk.nl, and you can tweet Ko at koturk77. So without further ado, I'd like to bring up our speaker, Ko Turk.
Yeah, thank you very much, Greg. A good introduction, thank you.
Thank you.
So let's start. Yeah, thanks for having me. Thanks for tuning in, everyone, in Denver, America. Live from the Netherlands, where it's now middle in the night, but I really love talking for you guys, so I always make time. I'm really enjoying. Yeah, let's begin. Imagine that you're a part of a racing team. You're the one behind the controls, like here. You're sitting behind the monitoring. You're making the decisions. You are talking to these people, and you need to create a strategy. You need to know how your car is doing, how are your tires are doing, and we are middle in a car race. Pit stops, forecasting, so there are a lot of things you really need to know, a kind of metrics you can see. Yeah, it's not only the driver or the team, it's in our case, it's also the developer who need to know some the strategy and the tactics and that kind of things. But what if we don't have this kind of information? We don't have the metrics. That sounds silly, right? But why don't we implement this not by default in our software? Yeah, we need to think about proper monitoring. You have a backend, and you have an application and a frontend there, and you really need to know if your application is performing good or not. You need to know, for example, that your tire is gone or something, but you're still driving. But yeah, those are kind of things you really need to know. But without metrics, it is tough. Yeah, if that's happening, you're thinking, oh, what do I need to do? I want to know, I have logging, of course. But yeah, you don't know where to look. You can log it, what I said, but that's not enough. Yeah, we can, of course, see kind of debugs, like you implement old-fashioned log4j or SLF4j. You can catch the exceptions. You can log the errors and that kind of things. And, oh, this is something happening, the exception here. And then you can debug it, but... yeah, if you are in, you're looking into your logging, you never see debug. So yeah, that's a pity, right? You only want to know if something goes wrong of performing, and yeah, and a log is an event that happens, and metric is a measurement of the health of a system. So see it like going to the doctor. You're going to the doctor when you're sick, right? You can tell him or her everywhere you went in the past week, but you mentioned things like you were at a food festival in the past days, then some birthday party in the office. And if you give your doctor enough clues about your history, he or she may possibly be able to pinpoint your ailment exactly. But you're missing some things, like you need to have your blood pressure, right? Or he or she wants to check your blood. That's more like a metric, because that's are things you can really check. And you want to have it instantly, like the blood pressure you can do. And yeah, that's more like a metric, how I see it. And that's where a micrometer comes in. So yeah, there can micrometer help us in combination with Spring Boot. You can also do it in with Micronaut. So, a little short introduction. My name is Ko Turk. I'm speaking what Greg said about IDEs and micrometer, also about contract testing. I like to drive the bike. I really love it. I'm working for Blue4IT. It's a small consultancy company in the Netherlands. I have an assignment at the Rabobank. It's not there, but I have my own suite. it's perfect for now. I have I can get my own coffee here and that kind of things. It's really nice. I love the tech stack. What we're using, I love what we're using. We're using Spring Boot, all kind of front technologies like TypeScript and Angular. We use in Java 14, Cloud Foundry, and Micrometer. So I'm going to talk more about that. The stack we are going to use is, of course, Micrometer in combination with Spring Boot. If you have some questions about Micronaut, it's also possible after this talk. Prometheus we are going to use like a backend system, a database system where we can save all this information or also can create graphs. And we have Grafana. So the goal of today, or the agenda, yeah, we are going to first, before I'm going to live code, it's in part two, we are going to define some metrics, because before you begin, you need to know what you need to monitor, right? So define the metrics. In the context of a car racing, we are going first to create a strategy. Behind the computers, you need to think of, hey, do I want to have two pit stops, for example, to refuel or save the tires or new tires? That kind of things, you really need to want to know it. Is it going probably to rain and that kind of things? But for that, you need metrics. What do we need to monitor? It can be, in our case, different things. Like I want to monitor the performance of an old soap call. I have some Kafka topics, for example, some consumers, producers. I want to know maybe what's going in, going out. I have some REST endpoints. I have a database call. That kind of things you can think of if you want to monitor. It can be all kind of things. I will come back to that later. There's also a really good book. It's also free. You can download it. It's this one from Google, how Google runs production systems. And it's a little bit about how to be good in DevOps. And yeah, I get this also from a recommendation from someone from VMware. It's yeah, I will save my slides later on. You can all download it then on my Twitter. So yeah, creating metrics. So we want to search for race factors, and that you can compare to SLIs. I make it quick, this one. Creating tactics, it's like SLOs, and creating a strategy is a service level agreement. Like we want to define an SLI. So we want to know how long does it take to do a pit stop. So we want to know a kind of performance, for example. We want to have an object. We want to do a pit stop not slower than 8 seconds, for example. That's the objective. And the agreement we have two pit stop less than 8 seconds. So that's more like an agreement. And now we are going to trying to implement it in Micrometer. And now we're going to prepare the car, a race. I'm going to say what you all can do with the Micrometer. So let's prepare the car. So we really want to know, hey, how can we monitor a car or health of a car? And it can help us. Micrometer for the win. But what is it? It is a kind of SLF for J. They say it on their website, but it's only this is only for metrics. So if you want to monitor interesting things. A reason to use it, we are using, for example, because we all use Spring Boot, Cloud Foundry. It's also easily integration. It's really simple. I really love Venkat Subramanian. He's always saying simplicity is always good. So I love the simplicity of Micrometer. You get a lot of free for free, and yeah, Micrometer is included in Spring Boot 2.x. It's just dependency and a Maven dependency, or if you have Gradle, next time I will add it, by the way. But it's just adding a dependency. And if you are pre Spring Boot 2.0, then it's a legacy dependency you need to add. So, and that's it. You're already good to go. So you can use it. So that's pretty awesome. And it's also there for Micronaut. It's just two dependencies, like the core and the management, and you have need one for the backend. And in this case, that's the take a glass of water. So you have all kinds of instrumentations, like caches, class loaders, garbage collection. You all have that for free, and you can get it from the actuator. in Spring Boot. Sorry for the white background, but but it's yeah, you get a lot of free. This is some of the free things you already get, like you can monitor your threads, even log back the CPU. You can all read it there, and that's just really nice. But now we're going to a demo. what should I do? I'm going to I'm first going to say what we can monitor. For example, we have long task timers. A long task timer is a timer that emits values even if the task is not finished. So you have two kind of timers. Later I will say something about the timer, but you can see it like it's a kind of a race. So you want to monitor the race, like the time in the race. How long are we busy already? And yeah, that is really something you can monitor. It's if it's not finished, then you see the time. So that it's perfect. You also have the timer. Yeah, we'll do that later. Check. I will share my screen. I will create. I'm using IntelliJ, so I'm going to live code now. So I'm trying to do it like this. I want a new project, like with the Spring initializer we mostly use, right? So let's go. So we have, for example, package ID. Dot car, and we call it race or something. Using Java 11, okay. And the only thing what I need is Spring Web, I really like, and the actuator. And as a backend system, you can also choose where it needs to expose the metrics. In my case, I want Prometheus. So, and we are good to go. So. Only next, we call it race, yeah, what you want. Do it in a new window, please. I'll change it, oops. And we have a new a project. So let's create a controller. So it's pretty easy, just create a car controller. And we're going to create our first metric. So it's just Spring Boot, right? So we have a REST controller, and we have the request mapping. And is how do we call it? Car race or something. Something like this. And we created our first controller. What also is very handy is just return something like we have a race, for example, race endpoint. Request mapping is just default. It's going to this one and it's racing. So what we want to know is, hey, yeah, we can also create a car, Formula One car, and we are going to create it. And create it. So where do we create it? In a, we have a domain package, and there we have our Formula One car. This needs to be a component in this case. And what do we want? We want to have, for example, have it a Formula One car. We want to have it driving. Like I just delete this one. Yeah, we have a Formula One car, and that's driving. And I added just a plain old thread sleep, where we can simulate that it's just driving, and we are going to use it. And we need to instantiate it, right? So, it's a little late. So we now have a car. So what we are going to do? A car.driving. Let's throw some exception. Okay, it's not about the coding style, but it's more about using Micrometer. So what we can do, we now have a method that simulates the racing. So what we can do is, for example, we can use the @timed annotation from Micrometer. And we can give it a name. We call it car.race long task timer or something. And the only thing you can you should do is adding a long task. And now we have our first metric. It's monitoring the race, so the time. So let's start Springwood. If the demo gods are with me. I was already listening. Oh, I still open it, I think, in another. So starting it again. So we now started the application, and what we now can see, I forgot also something like here, like we have an application. I like the YAML version. So a refactor. So what we want to know, also want to expose, because we are now have X-Rate, for example, but we don't have the metrics now. But you need to apply it to your YAML. So you need to say, hey, I want metrics. So we now have some default metrics, the health of our application, for example, but we're missing the metric part. So let's add it. So I also have a live template for that. And you can say, hey, I'm going to expose. Like I can expose to Prometheus, for example, or to Atlas, Datadog, a lot is possible. It's just exposing your metrics. I didn't apply any security, so you need to make sure secure your application secure, right? So that's very important. Otherwise, everyone can see it in your network. If that's a problem, I don't know. But yeah. So I now implement it and just stop and rerun. Perfect. So back to the car controller. I'm going to do this here. It's maybe handier. So if we do it now, refresh it, we have much more. And that's really nice, because we also have, like, for example, our metrics are going to be exposed to Prometheus, and we have the metrics. So we can do this, like the list I already show you. But our endpoint or metric, I also want in this view. So let's go to what do we have? Car, and now we have a race. So I'm now going to simulate the car race, because I had a thread.sleep. It's not good, of course, but yeah, it's simulating that we are racing now. And I also created car.race, was it, right? So what was the name of it? Oh, it was another name. You can also see it here if it's all good. And now we have the first one is this one. So this is pretty nice. And also click on it, maybe? No, it's not clickable. But yeah, now we have created our first metric. Hooray, yeah! So we now have a count of one. I'm only racing in one race, right? But yeah, so we have a duration now, and I thought—
Hey, Co?
Yeah?
Can you bump the fonts on that JSON so it's easier to read?
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Thank you.
Like this, right? Yeah, perfect. So like this, perfect. So that's really nice to see your first metric. So we have a duration, and if it's done, then I thought it was already going to value zero. So yeah, it's taking some time, you can see. So yeah, we can wait or we can go to the next one, I would say. It's done now. And then you can see you have a count of one and you have all kinds of different things you can also monitor. You can also see if there were exceptions or that kind of things. You can see the URL, the outcome of the last one. It was a 200, a success, and a count of one. And it counts to seconds now. So that's pretty awesome. And you have a max. So the second time, it will have a count of two and a total time. So yeah, that's really, really, really nice. So we now create our first metric, what I said. So we are going to the next one. We also have timers. And timers are intended for measuring short duration latencies and the frequency of such events. So it's like a short duration, like they do not record the duration until the task is complete. Like a pit stop, right? So I'm the car driver and I have a pit stop. The team need to know how long it was. If I change tires, for example, sometimes review, in the past it was reviewing, but they don't do it anymore now. But that's really, really, yeah, something you want to monitor. Yeah. So let's create a timer then. So again, we have a request mapping and we should name it pit stop. Something like this, and it's again some easy we call it, for example, pit stop. Don't look at the names or something, but yeah. And we want to have a Formula One car that's having a pit stop, so we're going to that one. And it's also, we want to have timer. It's not there, but we want, for example, I think it's from another one, it's also possible. I want, for example, to review. You have two possibilities. You have a review, and we can do a thread sleep again, like here. It's not driving. We already have it, like review and wait. So we have two possibilities. We can give back a duration, or we can give just a thread.sleep. In my first case, I only want a thread.sleep. And I do then a Formula One car, review and wait. That's something, and again, it's drawing some exceptions. And sometimes is that not what you want, but yeah, I will come to that later. Like you have a timed annotation again. And tada, I created a second metric, like car.race.timer. I created a timer with a pit stop. So now I'm only measuring short duration, like now it's just a timer. I will show it. Let's do it. And again, I'm going to check it. And we have a car race and we have it pit stop. And it's calling race, but it's a pit stop. But yeah, it's just what you give back, right? And if you look to the metrics, you now have a car race time, and you also see the other one with the race itself, it's gone. So that's what I meant with long task timer. It's only lost when it's there. So we have a car race timer. And what was it? We can do it like here. And here you have the count. So we now have a pit stop of 1.2 seconds. It's not reliable. It should be more normally, but it's very fast. But yeah, that's the total time and a max. But the next time, if I call it, you will see, hey, it's the second one. And total, it's 2.1. And the max is this one. So for example, you want to improve on your pit stop the next week or something. You can see, hey, my max pit stop was this. And I want to improve it, for example. And that's quite interesting metrics, I would say. There are multiple ways to go to Rome, like it's a Dutch sentence. So there are multiple ways to create some things. I can also do this. You'll have, for example, metrics dot, what do we want, for example, a timer. And a timer can have a name, right? So we can give it, for example, a name. Car dot race dot timer, timer two or something, give it a name. And then you can call record. And that's pretty interesting, like in you also have a duration you can give back. So instead of the car.refuel and wait, I can also call refuel. And that refuel is just giving a duration back. I'm just saying, hey, I want to give this amount of time back. Like I have a duration of 8 seconds and here you are. You don't need to wait. It's not blocking your threads and that kind of things. I can imagine that you want that. So you can also give a duration back. And it's pretty nice that you can do it like this. You can, now we also created our metric, but now with the duration and you don't need to wait. This is just the default you can use Micrometer. You also have the Prometheus way, and then it's also exposed. I thought it was even a default exposed, but yeah. You also have a timer.build, and you can also do things with it like this. I have a car.race.pitstop.timer3. And what is really cool about that is that you also can give tags with it. Timer, of course. Yes, we can give it tags. So like, I'm a huge fan of Red Bull, and Max Verstappen is a Dutch rider, sorry guys. And I really love it. And also Hamilton, he's the world champion. But yeah, we are a fan of Max, of course. We have Max Verstappen, he's driving the Formula One. And you can also register it later on with a registry. I can also create a Prometheus registry. First, I need to check my POM. It's always like this. I don't want the runtime scope. We can also create a Prometheus registry, like Prometheus. It's reload project because we're using this one. So we have also registry like this, and then we can expose it to Prometheus, for example. So for sure we need to instantiate it, right? So we also have a Prometheus registry now, and now I can say, hey, I want to register it at my Prometheus registry. What is it? Registry like this. Oh, it's text, by the way. So. And then you can also say, hey, the next time I want to have a tag with Hamilton or something, or yeah, you can also change it to Hamilton or what you want, or yeah. So you also can give tags to it that I know, hey, that timer is intended for that rider, because mostly in a team of Formula One, you have two riders, or two, not four. You can see that it's having tag Max Verstappen. So that's really cool. So that's also a really a need that you can use with Prometheus registry. Or in our case, we are mostly just using the annotation here, so the at times. That's really nice. So it's so simple. It's just an annotation, edit, and you're done. So why should we not edit? I would say, like, every developer who wants to measure the time should edit, I think. But yeah, that's a personal opinion. And yeah, next one. We can also expose it, by the way, to Prometheus. We already exposed it. Come back to that later. So yeah, let's go on. So you also have, for example, histograms. You want, for example, to check your pit stop, for example. You want to know, hey, what was the pit stop with a range of 0 till 2 seconds, for example, or 0 and 3 seconds, or maybe I only want the pit stops with 5 till 10 seconds. So yeah, histograms are really neat for that one. And yeah, it's nice to compare things. Like we can also edit here, like we have histograms. I'm just going to add this one. Yeah, for example, we want to measure things like the car. Just adding some things, and then it's. So here I created a get histogram. We want just to have a measurement between start and the end time, for example. And we can give it a timer. I gave it a name, my history of the timer, and it gives you some nice things, like you can get things in buckets, like see it like in math, you have a kind of graph that's doing like this, and then you can say, I only want from this point to that point. You can also register it, like this. And you can publish it. So let's start it. This is also the difficult part of micrometer only. If you want these kind of things, you really need to think of, hey, what do I want to measure? And almost everything's possible. So let's go other sides. Like we have a car that race, and we call it pit stops, it was right. So. And now we measured something, and we can also see it like here. It's here, this one. And we also have a histogram. Prometheus and Grafana, you can also search in buckets. Like in Prometheus, you also have something like Prometheus. I can also see it. So this is the format Prometheus expects it, the backend. This is grasping these kind of data and save it in their own system. And I will show it later also. And it's really cool, because you also have a timer, all kind of buckets. We had a pit stop, and we only want to have things lower than this one, for example. It was, how long was it? We can check it also. Yeah, but it's really nice what you can see, that you can check the buckets here, and you only have those buckets. I have from 0 to 10 seconds. You can define your own time in the buckets, and you can only, if you're interested in those buckets, you can grasp these. Like, I'm interested in pit stops lower or equal than this, for example. Then you can grab this data, for example, the time. Or you can grasp, I only interested in those things. Like, if you do it another time, you have more counts, of course. like you have two counts, and then I'm just, hey, I'm interested only in this time, and how many had I, or maybe like here, or yeah, that's really nice to compare data and make graphs of it, and just to check, hey, how can we improve the pit stop strategy, for example? How can we improve the time? Or yeah, you can also do it with all kind of things, right? So just an example, and it's really useful. And you can also give it percentiles, like you only want to search in a kind of buckets from this to this. And that's really neat also. And then you can do it like here. You can publish the percentiles, for example. And that's also really nice. And at the end, you do a time of the record. Yeah, and then you can also give the time unit. So I can also say, hey, only give me the seconds of the milliseconds, or yeah, just how you want it, what's best for your system. So that's more about histograms. So what I said, this is Prometheus. I will show it later also. And here you can see, for example, your buckets. You can see, hey, I have multiple buckets. And yeah, for example, you have 8 seconds, 7 seconds, and 5 seconds. And you can just check it if you want it. If you can check everything, or you can give some percentiles. I only want to this part. So yeah, it's really neat. The next one is the counter. This is really a simple one, just like the timed annotation. We just only want to count laps, like we're adding a lap. This is the world champion Hamilton, and yeah, we want to add a lap, for example. So let's add a lap, and again we want live template. I want to add a lap. Race, add lap. Request mapping. Lap, add lap or something. Adding a lap. That we can see, hey, that's adding alarm. You have multiple ways. Again, we can just use the metrics, for example, metrics counter. We don't have an annotation for this one. Even there is an add counter. There's even an add counter annotation, or you can use the metrics dot counter. And now, interesting. Just use this. It's also counted. It's also counted, and you can use that one. Perfect, and you can use the counter, and you can also give car race dot counter, and you can increment it. So every time I'm requesting to add a lap, it's incrementing the counter. It's only for positive values, so it's only go up. You can use another one if you want negatives. You can use another metric. I come to back to that later. And what is really neat is it's so simple. Yeah, it's simplicity. I like it also in your code. It's just what it is like. Or at times it's even better because yeah, it's just annotation, and yeah, it works a little different with Micronaut, of course. So we now have a lap, add lap, and there we're adding a lap. And you can see in the metrics that you have a car.race.counter, for example. So that's really nice. And we can do it like here again. So we have a counter, and it's only a simple counter. So yeah. Can also give it tags and base units, what the count is, descriptions, everything is possible. But I want to keep it simple, do it like this. So that's the counter, so that's pretty simple, right? We also have a gauge. like you want to monitor, for example, your tires. Are they doing good or not? And 100% is perfect. You're in Formula One, you have all sets of tires, like intermediates, wets, and that kind of things. And you want to know, for example, if they're doing good. I'm only checking the percentages, like if it's 100% or if it's 10%, then you know, hey, I need to change tires. Otherwise, I have a flat tire. Yeah, we want that. So let's create a gauge. So again, I'm a lazy developer, sorry. Just doing like this. Lazy is good, right? What are we going to do? We're going to create a gauge and we call it tires. I get tire, something like that. And again, yeah, you have something like that. You can just do it like here. Metrics dot gauge, and you can also give it a name like a car dot like this. This is not working, and just also switching. What do I need more? I'm just doing this. I have a live template for this one. Oh. Come on, what was it? Number, and we can give. Oh, first need to have an. In the domain class, we need to have something like. What do we want? Tire wear, right? So. This one. The tire wear, it's now 50, so 50 means like it's not good, but it's not bad. So you need to think of, hey, later on I need to change my tires. So you can say that, like car dot no, not review, what was it, get tire wear. And it's really neat. And now we created our last metric. So it's really neat, and now we just getting a value back, and it can be positive, and the next time it can be 100, or it can maybe it can be even negative for your case, if you not in this case because you have flat tire, I think then, but yeah, you can also make it negative, and you can send it like this. It's really easy. Yeah, you can also send it to the registry of Prometheus. This is just the default way. They recommend it like this because I thought it was performing better like this way. So yeah, we can again stop a rerun. And again, we can check, hey, in the metrics, I would expect some things here. I need to call it, of course, otherwise you don't see it. What was the name? Tires. It's middle in the night here, so thinking is hard. So you see now here, you see the carded gauge. So perfect, and we can set it also back, and perfect, we have a value. So we have a value of 50 back, so we can also monitor on that. How great is that? How perfect is that? That you have something like this, that you can just easily see it. Like, yeah, in we have logging systems, right? Like Splunk and that kind of things. It's pretty awesome, pretty handy. But this is adding value to the monitoring part, so you want to have it instantly. And for Splunk, yeah, you need to wait and that kind of things. And yeah, you want to have a dashboard instantly like this, so it's perfect. Yeah, so we created our next one. Later on, I will say something about Prometheus, but now I will go on with my presentation about security. What I said, please implement security, Spring Security. It's very important. I now excluded it just to be very easy, that I can show you easily how Micrometer is working and not basic security. Otherwise, you will expose your endpoints to others. And I don't know if you want that. And definitely in a cloud of environment, you don't want it. So yeah. And don't forget to add it in your database config of Prometheus, for example, that you have authorization. You can all find it in some how-tos. So the next step is we want to have it in Prometheus. Where to store the metrics is the question, and which database should I use? You have all kinds of databases or backend systems like Graphite, Atlas, Kairos, Prometheus. I'm just using Prometheus, and you need to think of, hey, are they persistent or not persistent? Like if I, for example, I can deploy to Cloud Foundry, to cloud environment, and or Amazon or what you want. And you need to think of, hey, do I want to save it? Do I want to have my history? So you need to check that. Otherwise, the next restart, it's gone maybe. Probably if you don't install it. And you, yeah, the way you can expose it to Prometheus is just another endpoint, or you can even do it to Graphite. In the past, we were using Graphite, and it's very easy. You could just change only the Maven POM or the Gradle, and that's it. And then it's exposing Graphite, and yeah, it's pretty easy and simple. So sorry again for the white background. Next time I will do it. And then you have something like what Prometheus can read. So I've shown you already, right? So, but how to configure your application? I hope you can see it. Now I started in the terminal, I started Prometheus. You can just download it. Oh, this is Grafana, by the way. And it's just, you can do it like this, Prometheus, and you're good to go. And it's really easy. So it's listening on 1990. I thought it was, yeah, it's 1990. So if we are exposing our information to a Prometheus, it's going to this slash 1990. And here you are. You also have Prometheus where you can do check graphs, for example. We already exposed some things like car, what do to a quote, car dot race, what was it? What was the, yeah, labs, I hope we have it. You can check, no data, yeah, first need to check it, for example. Oh, this, yeah, labs. Oh, add lab, what's add lab? Yeah, so I hope we have it now here. Race, do we have something? Yeah, you can also check all these kind of information like the timers, what I said, and the count, seconds max. Do we have this one? We have this one. So we have the timers, for example. We had something here, right? So like we had a timer here, this one is now checking the pit stop, so you can check your failures there like you can do in Prometheus. Yeah, it was this one. Yeah, so you can use this one, or you can just use a nice tool to read it from Prometheus like Grafana. So you can also do some all kind of things here. You can, but I prefer something like Grafana or SignalFX or Datadog or that kind of things to visualize. It's also a kind of alerting you have there if you want an SMS or email or maybe a message on the Zoom or Teams. I don't know what's possible there, but yeah, I can imagine that you also want that if you are standby, for example, to in the middle of the night. Yeah, then you want to have a text message before customers are calling, right? like I'm getting. So that's pretty neat. So and we want to visualize it with Grafana. Like what is really cool of Mercedes is that they have a pit wall. And you can also see it like in our situation, we also want a pit wall. We want our own pit wall where we can see our application health. Like we want to see our pit stops. This is one of previous year I did, or the year before even with Rosberg. But I really like this one. You can see the laps, what we did, for example, the overtakes, the faster laps. And this is giving the team some insights to create a strategy. Hey, how are you doing and how can we perform better? Or maybe we have a critical situation and we need to react right away. We need a pit stop because your tires are very weak and that you need to know that, right? So we are going to create something similar like in Grafana. Which monitor systems are there? Like I said, you have Grafana, Datadog, Dynatrace Instance, Signalfix, and many more. There are a lot of them. They all have their own positive things. So I should say, look at it. It's really nice. But we want to go to deep dive into Grafana in this case. It's just, again, it's also what I said with terminal. Like, we also have a server here. You can just install it and just start it, like here. And we can just copy it. Now, where are we? Oh, sorry for the switching. Oh, here we have Grafana. I already logged in, so you don't need to see that. You can create your first data source. You can just saying, hey, I want to have Prometheus and selecting it. And okay, ta-da, it's testing, save and test. Oh, bad gateway because, I'm creating a second one, but yeah. And you can, off you go. You can just create your dashboard. Dashboard home. Can I already add something? Create a dashboard. Yeah, we can add a query, for example. Like, hey, we want a metric. What kind of metrics do we have? We have car.race. What do we want? We already have some information, like the gauge, let us set. We have a counter, like here. What do we want to know? For example, the tires, right? Do we have something already? Yeah, I have something. Now you can see how late it is at my time now. Pretty neat. Visualization. You can use a graph for what you want, or just like this. And here you can see, hey, we just want to have something like this. And what is it? What is it? It's just the tires. How are the tires doing? So you can set all kind of things. I want to have a measurement. I want to not to have it on red on 20. I want to have it on 20, for example. Oh, it's, and I want to edit the base. Can I change this? I want to in the middle is 50 or something like this. And like here, and now you see, hey, it's now the green needs to be here. Can I change it somewhere? But yeah, you need to, maybe we can make it green or something. Yeah, we can make it green. So it's now green, for example, but the next one is orange. And this one is red, for example. So here you can see, hey, now I don't like this green. I want this green. Yeah, not this one, even better. Yeah. So it's pretty neat. You can just check. We created our first metric and just a simple one. So we can edit and we just save it, save dashboard, and we create a new dashboard, whatever, save and override. Okay, so we created our first metric. How simple is it? You can all, of course, you can also add another one. I can do this like here. And I add a panel, and maybe I want to have something else, like a car.race. What do we have? The counted laps, for example. is, do we have something? Yeah, we have something. We have added two labs. Maybe I want to have just something like a single stud. It's only the first lap, probably, or it's the average, I would say, total, I would say. Yeah, it's two. So, and then you can give it a color, what? Give it purple. Something like this. And now you created a second one on Grafana. So it's also save it again. Maybe give it a nice title and current lab or something. Give it a name. Oh, I don't want to share it. So yeah, save it. And I want to go back. And now we have added another one. So it is really nice. And maybe you also want to create another one. You can just the last one and then I go on. You can also add, for example, car dot what do we have? The long pass time. Hey, where is it? Seconds. The count, I would say. Race time. Seconds count, I would say. This one. We have something. Yeah, we have a count with, for example, two pit stops, for example. And you can also do it like this, a bar. And I don't want the left and a shoulder, right? This one, what's handy? I don't want to share the time, but series maybe. I is maybe handy. It's a total, and maybe we want a total. I want to have the, was it max like this? So we now have something like seems like a pit stop amount of pit stops. And again, we created, I'm going to again share it, sorry. So we now create a third metrics, and now we can also see the amount of metrics. And of course, you can also add graphs if you want, like the time and that kind of things. You can also change it to just two without decimals, right? So yeah, you cannot have 2.5 pit stops. So this is really neat. So a lot is possible, right? And you can even add alerting to it. So yeah, every backend system, some backend systems can do it, like Grafana is really useful. I really love it. So back to the presentation. So we created, you can, for example, have a long task time and the duration. The total race time in seconds you can create. You can have a timer, what I've shown you, like you have one amount. You can even check the seconds, right? The best time it was 5.5 seconds, the pit stop. So that's very good, perfect. You can also have the worst, right? So what I've shown you also, this one, the gauge, the tires. You can also, the cars in race, like you already have it, GVM treads, for example. And those are 20 in this case, and you have 20 cars. And it's, yeah, if one is dead, then you have 90. And yeah, that's pretty cool. And then you have a dashboard, something like this. That's how you race and how you can race. And how you can win the race, you really need to think about your team strategy, right? So don't to forget, next time if you're going to program developers, think about metrics. It's so easy, just implement a dependency and you're good to go. And it's take me 5 seconds to add an annotation to check the performance, right? So that's really nice. So I hope you have something useful in this, so you can use it the next time when you're working. So, and yeah, that's how you can win the race with those kind of metrics, and how you can think of your own application, how to be a DevOps engineer. So thank you for listening. All examples you can find at my GitHub. I will later on send it also through my Twitter. So please follow me. I will also have it there, my slides, for example. And if you have some questions, now is the time. And otherwise, I'm available on Twitter or on LinkedIn or yeah, whatever you name it. So yeah, thank you for watching. Back to you, Matt.
All right, so we do have some questions.
Okay. Let
me start with the first one. A random guy asks whether metrics can be achieved for the last completed REST service call, or is it only for the running one?
You can have you have a count, right? So you have a long task time, a duration, and it gives you everything, and it's measure all your everything when you every time when you count it or request the endpoint, then you see the measurements, right? So if I have a count of two, then you can see the duration, right, in seconds or milliseconds. And is that a kind of answer the question, or?
I'm not sure. I'm going to say yes.
Okay.
We'll move on to the next one. Yeah. This one's from Jim Fox. He says, is Micrometer just an abstract package and there's no firmware to real hardware?
Whew.
So he follows that up with another one that says, if so, like if it does have, you know, a firmware IF or interface to real hardware, how would you compare it to other packages like Raspberry Pi or wearables or Fitbit or anything like that?
The only thing I know now is that you can use it in Spring Boot, and it's just in Spring Boot, it's just a dependency. And what it does with hardware, I have no idea. I think, it's just out of the box from Spring, so you can use it for your software, and I think you can also use it not using a Spring Boot. You can even use it like what I said in Micronaut, you have dependencies, and I guess you can also use it out of Spring Boot, but I've never done that with for example Raspberry Pi or something, but
right. And I would agree with you, I don't know that there's any hardware that's part of the project. It is more, it's like SLF4J, like you said, for logging, right? It's a way of collecting metrics and then sending them somewhere else, and that somewhere else could be hardware, but that's not part of Micrometer as a project.
Correct. Yeah. Thanks.
All right. So the next one is, how does the counter and gauge work if the applications are deployed in multiple machines?
That's a good one. That's a good one. How do we do that? It's just scraping. So like you have an endpoint, like if you have two applications, you have an endpoint for Prometheus, and for example we are using Cloud Foundry, and they just scrape it, right? And you have a kind of configuration you can set where you can go to the database, for example. But I think Prometheus should know how you can, it's there you can set your scraping interval. I want to show you, maybe I can show you.
Well, we did have a couple suggestions just in the chat. One was from Jim. He recommended using like a relational database, right, to store it.
Yeah.
And then another person suggested that Prometheus logs the source.
Yeah,
or you could add one, and then you could query by the instance, right? So you could know where it's coming from.
Like, so you still see my screen?
Yep.
You can add targets here. I think you can also add targets here. So we are just using a configuration. We don't need to set targets because Cloud Foundry is let us know that. So you have your targets here. You can, you also have your basic authentication, right?
Nice. All right, so that's all the questions we had from the chat. Perfect. Thank you for your time tonight, and looks like it's almost 3 o'clock in the morning for you, so we'll let you get to bed, and we really appreciate you hanging out with us tonight and sharing your knowledge.
Yeah, thank you very much for having me. I really enjoyed, Matt. Thank you for inviting me. I really like it like this. I really like talking. So you make my day also. So thank you.
All right. Well, thanks to everyone who showed up, and we'll see you later.
Okay.